Chronic exposure to dust during underground coal mining puts miners at risk for black lung disease and other respiratory illnesses. The characteristics of coal mine dust vary according to mine geology and mining practices. It is likely that more than one type of particle in the dust contributes to disease risk in miners. In the 1960s, black lung disease was found in 30% of miners who had worked in coal mines for at least 25 years. In 1969, regulatory requirements put limits on the airborne concentration of coal mine dust and its concentration of crystalline silica, which is a known contributor to lung disease. Those requirements, along with improved medical surveillance programs, were successful in reducing the cases of black lung. By 2000, only 5% of coal miners who had worked 25 years or more had the disease. Yet miners are still at risk. Since about 2000, the National Institute for Occupational Safety and Health reported an upward trend in cases of black lung disease in coal miners who have worked 15 or more years. More recently, severe and fatal forms of the disease have been documented in central Appalachia. The reasons for the increase in lung disease are not clear, but could be related to changes in mining practices. For example, the use of heavier, more powerful equipment has made it easier to cut through more rock to mine thinner coal seams. If that rock is high in crystalline silica, miners could be exposed to dust with elevated concentrations of silica, which can increase health risks. A federal requirement issued in 2014 lowered the allowable dust concentration in underground coal mines and requires miners in occupations with high dust exposure to use continuous personal dust monitors on a periodic basis. The portable monitors measure exposure in near real time so that mine operators can take immediate corrective actions when dust readings are high. These actions can include increasing ventilation or using more water spray. In addition, coal miners wearing monitors might lower their own dust exposures by modifying their activities or locations. However, only a small fraction of miners are required to use a personal monitor during any given shift. Although total dust concentrations are monitored in real time, the crystalline silica content of the dust is not. Collected samples must be mailed away to a laboratory for analysis, leaving no opportunity to take immediate corrective actions in response to elevated silica concentrations. Data from industry monitoring indicate more than 99% compliance with federal dust control regulations. But that is not a guarantee future disease rates will decline. To make continued progress toward the goal of eliminating black lung disease, mine operators need to go beyond current regulations. Additional voluntary monitoring and sampling are needed to better detect and analyze dust exposures. In addition, government agencies need to support research on the relationship between exposure and disease, and the effects of changes in mining practices on coal mine dust characteristics. Research is also needed to improve monitoring methods, such as developing rapid detection of crystalline silica, and to find ways to increase miners' participation in medical surveillance programs.